What we do to our planet today will dictate how the future unfolds on Earth. 10 million years from now, our solar system will either be completely devoid of life, or, on the opposite side of the spectrum, we might see human beings evolve way beyond our current reality and become a multiplanetary species. The Earth that we know today is at least 4.54 billion years old, but we are relatively young compared to the cosmos. Our solar system occupies a tiny place in the vastness of the universe. The origin of our solar system is crucial in knowing what the future will look like, because this will give us the right historical context of our own planet, where we come from, and where we're going. If you want to see what the future holds for humanity, stick around till the end of the video to discover the state of our planet 10 million years from now. Our solar system was formed during the same time as our sun. At least, that's what the nebular hypothesis tells us. If this is your first time hearing about the nebular hypothesis, well, this scientific theory states that a spinning cloud of dust made of mostly light elements called nebula flattened into a protoplanetary disk and then became a solar system consisting of a star with several planets orbiting around it. The spinning nebula recollected most of the materials in the center, and that is why the sun accounts for 99% of the entire mass of our solar system. After the solar system was formed, the nebular cloud dispersed several particles, which then developed distinct temperature zones. The temperatures were very high, close to the center, only allowing condensation of metals and silicate materials with extremely high melting points. Much farther from the sun, the temperatures were lower, which allowed condensation of larger gaseous molecules like carbon dioxide, water, methane, and ammonia. This could be the reason why the four inner planets of the solar system became a rock mass and the outer four planets became gas giants. But just because these planets are different in their physical makeup does not mean that they are entirely different. Both rocky and gaseous planets have very similar growth models. Particles of dust that are floating in the disk were attracted to each other by static charges and gravity. When the particles of dust collected together to form bigger clumps of dust, they interacted with each other and formed protoplanets. The planets continue to grow over the course of millions of years, when more materials from the protoplanetary disk were added. The common theme between rocky and gaseous planets would be the fact that they started with a very solid core. But the rocky planets accumulated more rock on that core, and the gaseous planets added gas and ice instead. That's the history of our solar system in a nutshell. But what happened on planet Earth specifically? Well, geoscientists use timescales to assign the relative age names to events and rocks that separate major events in the Earth history based on significant changes that were recorded in rocks and fossils. The Hadean Aeon, named after the Greek god and ruler of the underworld Hades, is the oldest aeon that dates back to 4.5 to 4.04 billion years. This is the time that represents Earth's early history, when the planet was just a molten surface with volcanism and asteroid impacts. The gravitational compression, radioactive decay, and asteroid impacts made the Earth what it is today, at least during the initial stages of the formation of our planet. It might not be a surprise to you that most of this still exists inside the core of our planet. Maybe life could also have existed 4 billion years ago, but the most reliable record for early life is a microfossil record that's about 3.5 billion years old. As the Earth cooled from its molten state, minerals started to crystallize and settle, which resulted in the separation of minerals based on density, and that resulted in the creation of crust, mantle, and core that we know today. The high melting point minerals formed solid slabs of early crust once the Earth started cooling down, but these slabs were quite unstable and might have easily reabsorbed into the liquid magma until Earth was cooled to allow numerous larger fragments to form into a very thin primitive crust, something very similar to the Moon's current surface. The Earth then cooled and solidified, and as a result, the less dense minerals floated to the surface of the Earth to form the crust, while the denser material flowed inside the Earth to form the mantle, and the highest density iron and nickel sank to the core. This is that one factor that differentiated Earth from other planets in the solar system. So now that we know about the past and present day Earth, it's time to address the elephant in the room. And that is, how will Earth look like 10 million years from now? Well, it may not be easy for us to predict the future, like how we can make a hypothesis about the past, because we're talking about not 1 or 2 years, or even a decade, but 10 million years moving forward. It's highly likely that all the inhabitants of our planet would be in a much superior state than what they are today, all thanks to evolution. Some of the species might also face mass extinction due to an enormous asteroid or comet impact. Orbital instabilities in the solar system may eventually result in catastrophic collisions between Earth and other terrestrial planets like Venus, Mercury, or Mars. But the possibility of that taking place is just about 1% in the next 5 billion years. No, not 5 million years, 5 billion years with a B. The most likely scenario for Earth, if at all, it were ever to destroy, would be when it engulfs into the Sun as the Sun transforms into a red giant star. The Sun's thermonuclear fuel, hydrogen, will become depleted in its core, and the star's outer envelope will begin to expand. This is the phase where the Sun will lose a significant amount of mass, meaning the Earth's orbit will also expand. But there are theories that suggest that the new orbit won't be large enough for the Earth to escape the interaction with the expanding atmosphere of the Sun. This means that there are high chances that the Earth will still be swallowed by the growing star. But this will take place after 7.59 billion years in the future. But let's say that if our planet somehow survives and remains in orbit around the red giant Sun, the Earth's natural orbital decay would mean that it would merge with the dead Sun. But the chances of this happening will only occur at about 100 billion years moving forward. Keep in mind that the universe is only about 13 billion years old now, so we still have a lot of time. The geological features of the Earth can be studied based on the estimated effects of several long-term influences of what happened in the past, and also based on what happens today. Geologists could learn about the chemistry of the Earth's surface, the cooling rate of the planet's interior, or even the gravitational interaction with other objects in the solar system, along with a steady increase in the Sun's luminosity. But most of the changes that can affect our planet in 10 million years from now will take place as a result of human activities, which could cause significant changes to our planet. The effects of what we do today might last for more than 5 million years. This means that the technology that we create to help us overcome our physical barriers might backfire and result in the extinction of humanity, especially if AI takes over. Random cosmic activities could pose a huge risk to the biosphere, which means mass extinction would be a common event on our planet moving forward. This could be because of comets or asteroids, or the possibility of a massive stellar explosion known as the supernova. The luminosity of the Sun will also steadily increase, resulting in the rise of solar radiation reaching the Earth, which will then result in higher rates of weathering of silicate materials that will affect carbonate silicate cycle, which would then decrease the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. But that will only happen in about 600 million years from now, where the level of carbon dioxide will fall below the level needed to sustain C3 carbon fixation and photosynthesis. Humans play a major role in the biosphere because we dominate some of the world's largest ecosystems. This also resulted in several mass extinctions. The biotic crisis, as a result of human beings, ever since the 1950s, resulted in an estimated 10% loss of the total species on our planet as of 2007. So in the next 100 years, 30% of all the species that are on the planet might get extinct. Unless we take radical action to preserve life on Earth starting from today, you could just imagine how 10 million years moving forward would look like. Yes, 10 million years is a long time, and unfortunately, we don't have a crystal ball to predict the future with 100% accuracy. Maybe our Earth could be the last place to support life in our solar system, and the future aliens who would be visiting our planet would be left clueless as to what happened on Earth, without knowing that life had once flourished on our blue planet. Aliens might even conclude that they are the only life forms in the cosmos, just like how we now think that we are alone in the universe.